good evening and welcome to Northeast Gateway News. I'm Sangeeta with you. Let's first know the headlines. Bharatiya Janata Party's massive protest in Assam against Home Minister Shinde. Galo Welfare Society demand for arresting all accused in UDIF murder case Itanagar. Insurgency had made a threatening call for creating terror in Assam on the eve of 26 January. His Excellency the Government of Manipur greeted in the eve of Republic Day. CEO Nagaland appeals for free, fair and peaceful election. Handless artist inspires the disabled. Sikkim gets year's first snowfall. Now news in detail. Bharatiya Janata Party's massive protest against Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde's Hindus terror remarks rocks in Guwahati. The Saffron Party takes to the street and burn effigy of the Home Minister. BJP National Secretary Shama Jaju opinions that the Congress has resorted cheap publicity and vote bank politics. With the rest of the country, the BJP in Assam took to the streets of capital Guwahati, demanding resignation of Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde. BJP National Secretary Shyam Jaju, who led the protest from the front, demanded that Sushil Kumar Shinde should resign from the post of Home Minister of the country and the Congress should apologize before the country for such an irresponsible remark. Slogans against Sushil Kumar Shinde reverberated Guwahati streets. Protesters even blocked the main thoroughfare of capital Guwahati.
देश के होम मिनिस्टर सुशील कुमार शिंदे जी ने जयपुर के कांग्रेस के शिविर में बहुत इर्रिस्पॉन्सिबल बयान दिया है। ये बेबुनियाद बयान के खिलाफ आज देश भर में धरना प्रदर्शन का कार्यक्रम भारतीय जनता पार्टी की ओर से हो रहा है और हम इससे मांग कर रहे हैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी की ओर से कि इस प्रकार का बयान देने वाले होम मिनिस्टर सुशील कुमार शिंदे जी का इस्तीफा होना चाहिए और कांग्रेस को इसके लिए देश के सामने अपोलॉजी करना चाहिए कि उन्होंने देशभक्त संगठन राष्ट्रीय स्वयंसेवक संघ और भारतीय जनता पार्टी जैसे पार्टी पर जो बेबुनियाद आरोप किए हैं इसको निरस्त होना चाहिए। हम जन आंदोलन कर ये भावना लोगों तक पहुँचाएंगे और लोगों को इसमें शामिल करेंगे। कांग्रेस ने ये कहने के लिए भी पल्ला झाड़ने के लिए भी 8 दिन लगाए कि हमारा इसका कोई संबंध नहीं है। इस प्रकार का आदमी देश के होम मिनिस्टर पे रहना ये कोई उचित बात नहीं है। कांग्रेस ने ये इलेक्शन पर्पस के कारण मुस्लिम तुष्टिकरण एक बार वापस सिद्ध करने के लिए अपने पास कोई भी सबूत ना होते हुए इस प्रकार का गैर जिम्मेदाराना बयान दिया है।
The Galo Welfare Society in a representation has urged the state chief minister to ensure arrest of all accused in Gautu Udik murder case as demanded by the Upper Subansiri Action Committee on the case. Informing that Udik Assistant Secretary General Protocol, Galo Students Union was stabbed to death at Alo General Ground on January 10th last. The representation demanded to institute an impartial judicial inquiry into the case within the next 2 weeks. To ensure that this kind of impartiality, your government may need to either change the guards in the West Siang District Administration, which is also accused of dereliction of duty in this particular case, if not put the concerned officer on suspension, the representation added. The three-point demand of the action committee was endorsed by GWS in a joint meeting on January 21st. The representation expressed its apprehension, said that the situation may go further out of control if the three steps are not taken immediately. Meanwhile, the Galo Students Union GSU in a release today informed that the agitation against government and administration scheduled on January 22nd and 23rd was called off following appeal from the Action Committee of UDIC murder case and the Galo Welfare Society. However, the union said that it will go ahead with its proposed Chakka Jam ban from 5 a.m. of January 24th to 5 a.m. of January 26th in the Galo-dominated areas in protest against non-fulfillment of its various demands, including immediate arrest of all co-accused in Gautu Udik murder case. The security agencies of Assam said ULFA and NDFB insurgency had made a threatening call for creating terror in the state in order to show their power and strength before and after the Republic Day. The police officials have made all the arrangements to secure Kokrajhar borderland, including all the local areas for a peaceful and safe Republic Day celebration. Tight security arrangements have been made near the railway tracks and railway stations. The ULFA and NDFB insurgency group called for a straight bun on the eve of Republic Day in Assam. Seeing the whole scenario, the deputy commissioner set up all the safety measures and promised the security of each and individuals of Kokrajhar. Our correspondent added,
"In terms of violence, we are more careful and more vigilant this time. And we are very hopeful that with this vigilance, we'll be able to take care of the antisocial elements and the celebration will be very peaceful. Republic Day ka whatever arrangement we have made, firstly we have beefed up security. We have ensured that all the security agencies, CPMF, army, police, they make a coordinated effort. And the celebration should be in befitting manner and very peaceful."
Union Petroleum Minister V. Mauli on Thursday during a news conference responded to a reporter's query on a latest turn of events in Dimapur, second constituency branded the Aur Sanso Talamjam Dimapur public declaration of support to NPF candidate Lipok Pongen as market news, which the Congress need not be worried of. He also said that the Congress would come back to power with full strength to take forward the agenda together, as the Congress alone was capable of providing a future agenda of development and social justice for the tribal. Falero said that Congress Chief Sonia Gandhi, Vice President Rahul Gandhi, Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde and former Home Minister P. Chidambaram are very much concerned about the political settlement and they are taking personal interest. Former Chief Minister Dr. S. C. Jamir said that the Congress as a party was united, harmonious and cohesive and determined to make a new Nagaland. NBCCI is an integral part of an Indian National Congress which believes in the unity of country and the sanctity of the constitution. The focus of the party was in the well-being of the people and to ensure the benefit should be all for Nagas.